Fans, something that's got the whole world of professional wrestling talking, the WWA, is a new addition, the Kentucky Butcher. For many, many years, Yukon Moose Sholak has enjoyed the privilege of being the biggest man in the WWA and possibly the biggest man in wrestling. And now Moose is stymied because yours truly, Dr. Jerry Graham, has had the foresight, knowledge, and wisdom to go out and recruit new talent to bring new wrestling into the WWA. And one of my newest and most fondest recruits, a man who'll surely be the rookie of the year in the WWA, the Kentucky Butcher. And Butcher, the people here, I'm sure, want to hear some of your insights on what you think about the North in general and Moose Sholak in particular.
I don't like Yankees and I don't like Sholak. I don't like him. He's too small. I whoop him.
In other words, you don't think he's big enough to give you proper competition?
No, he's not.
I don't think he is either, as a matter of fact. In fact, I've been told that down in Harlan, Kentucky, that there's people in kindergarten that are as big as Moose Sholak.
A guy that don't even graduate from kindergarten tells me that I am nothing. Listen, this guy has been going around dressing rooms around the country telling other wrestlers that he's going to pick up big Yukon Moose Sholak and slam him in the ring. Impossible. Nobody can do that. Well, now listen, punk, you're a punk to me, and when you didn't graduate from kindergarten, you ain't telling me
nothing. Wait a minute.
And your mother should have took you behind the barn when you
came
home and gave you
a big weapon. I'm trying to conduct an intelligent interview here, and I don't need to listen to your big mouth. I gotta tell you something. Moose Sholak, this man here, the Kentucky Butcher, could pick up a guy twice your size and slam him. I'm gonna tell you something. Kentucky Butcher, you know, I'm gonna tell you something. I've been down in Harlan, Kentucky. I heard you were down there. You used to work in the coal mines until you got too big to get into the mines. And then you fought in the Union Wars down there. I mean, everybody knows about bloody Harlan, Kentucky and the Union Wars. Let me ask you this. Whose side did you fight on? Did you fight for the company or did you fight for the unions?
Depending on who wanted to pay me more.
I mean, you'd go back and forth. Whoever had the money, whoever had the bread had the butcher, right?
That's right.
And is this kind of why you came up north now to work for Dr. Graham? Because I laid some bread on you, right?
That's right.
Now, I notice this big mouth. I don't know what he is. Let me finish talking. You've got a big mouth.
He can't count $2 in his pocket. What is he? He thinks $2.
Let me tell you something. When you get into the ring, Moose Sholak, you're not going to have a reading and writing contest with the Kentucky Butcher. You're not going to have a money counting contest with the Kentucky. You're going to have an old-fashioned wrestling match, as they say down in bloody Harlan, Kentucky. And this man doesn't look a bit worried. Moose. I mean,
I'm ready for this big Kentucky Butcher. I want to see him slam me. I want to see how big and strong he really is.
Well, the promoters tell us that this match is in the works, and we might see it in the WWA before you know it. Another edition of Graham's Gallery. Thank you.